If you're starting a YouTube channel this year, then chances are one of your biggest struggles is finding the time to edit. Editing is basically the most time-consuming part of the YouTube creation process, especially if you're trying to make your videos as engaging as possible by adding in lots of like sound effects, B-roll, graphics to optimize your videos for viewer retention and the algorithm. But there are several ways that you can make the video editing process faster, and you don't have to be an expert to make them work. So today I wanted to share 5 beginner editing hacks that are gonna make you way faster when you're editing in DaVinci Resolve. Okay, so I know file organization might sound boring, but it's actually one of the biggest ways that you can save your future self editing time. Just tell me in the comments if this is relatable. You just finished filming a new video and you're so excited to start editing. So you start a new project and you import the footage, and then you realize that you need to like go download some background music and oh yeah, go find those sound effects that you used in a previous video, and maybe that graphic that you designed about a month ago would be really helpful in this edit too. So now you have to go searching through all of your old folders to find these various assets, and it just all ends up taking forever. I'm gonna show you a process that helps you avoid all that frustration. First, you're gonna take the clips from that video that you just shot, and you're gonna organize them all into folders based on scene. For example, let's take a look at this video that I shot for tips on how to film yourself. So inside this folder, which is for the entire video, I have these subfolders. I've got one where all of my A-roll lives. I've got my like Flow 2 Pro demo shots all in one folder. I shot a specific like skincare routine example scene, and I've put all the clips there. This not only helps me find the footage that I need for the section that I'm editing when I'm working on this video, but it will also save me time in the future if later on I'm like, oh yeah, it would be really helpful to have a B-roll clip of me like doing my skincare routine. Well, I can find it. Once you've got down the routine of organizing the footage for your current project, it's also very important that you keep an organized assets folder. This is what mine looks like. I have subfolders for B-roll, animations, brand assets, the music that I use, the static graphics I need. For me, that's stuff like my lo-fi background music that I use in all my videos, mouse click sound effects, or overlays that I use again and again, like this light leaks one or this film grain one. I keep them all organized in this assets folder and down in subfolders as well, so they're easy to find. Thirdly, as you film more B-roll of yourself, you're gonna wanna have a B-roll library. This is mine. It's quite extensive at this point, and I have it organized into subcategories, as well as all of the clips are named in such a way that I'll be able to search keywords to find them. My general process for gathering these clips looks like this. As I film a new video, I will get specific B-roll that I've shot just for that video. So in the short term, that B-roll is gonna live in this folder, you know, alongside all of the other clips that I filmed for that specific video. But eventually, space on my hard drive is gonna fill up, so I'm gonna have to move these specific video folders onto my archive drive. So before that happens, what I like to do is go through and pick out any relevant B-roll that I think I'm gonna be able to use again. I will copy it over into that B-roll folder and rename it accordingly so it's searchable later on. Okay, so with all that organization done, it's time to start a new project in DaVinci Resolve. You can just open up Resolve, right-click anywhere that's blank, and then click New Project, and then give it a name. Once it's created, I recommend going up to File, and then Project Settings, and making sure that these settings align with the footage that you're about to import. So for me, I'm gonna make sure that it's 4K, and I'm actually gonna change the timeline frame rate over to 30 frames per second, because that's the frame rate that I film all of my footage in. Okay, so back to our files. First, you're gonna go down to this editing panel. This is how I always like to view DaVinci Resolve. I just find it more intuitive. On the left here, this is our media pool. This is where all of our clips are gonna live. So to actually import your files, all you're gonna do is open up a Finder window, select the folder that you want to import for your latest video here, and click and drag this folder into this column over here, the far left column under the word master. And you can see it has beautifully preserved all of the folders that we've created. It's turned them into bins, so all of our footage is nicely organized here. Now, it's very important that you make sure to drag the folder into this column over here, because you'll see if you don't, if you just drag it into this big media pool area, it will import all of your files into one big bin. So our file organization is now lost, like all that work that we did to create separate folders. So you can prevent that by just making sure that you drag it into this column over here, and then it's kept all of our folders. So in addition to that folder that's specific to the video you're working on right now, you're also going to want to bring in that assets folder. And again, if you drag it into this master column on the far left, it will preserve the file organization and you'll be able to go into all of your different subfolders and find what you need to find for your video. Okay, so last thing with file organization, this is one of my favorite features in Resolve. Let's just say you've imported all of your footage here and you're starting to edit, but as you go, you end up having to download other clips or maybe you film some more clips and you add them to your folder here, like on your computer. All you have to do to get the new clips that you've added to that same folder into Resolve is go ahead and right click in the media pool and click resync files. And you'll see that all of the clips that are in your A-roll folder are now matching everything in your A-roll folder in Resolve without you having to go through and select which clips still need to be imported. This is especially helpful when you're dealing with lots and lots of footage. Tip number two is to know your keyboard shortcuts. Personally, I have my keyboard shortcuts set up to kind of mimic the Premiere Pro shortcuts, since that's where I learned to edit and I edited in Premiere Pro for like 15 years. So it's just like muscle memory at this point. If you want, you can grab my same exact keyboard shortcuts for free. I've linked like the file in the description below. And if you want to use them, you just need to open up Resolve, go to the top left, click on DaVinci Resolve here, and then click on keyboard customization. In the top right-hand corner of this panel, yours will probably say just DaVinci Resolve here. If you click on these three dots, then you can import a preset. And from here, you can just import the file that you've downloaded at the link below. So here are the main keyboard shortcuts that you need to know. And just so you know, these will only work if you've installed my keyboard shortcuts, because otherwise there'll be different ones that come in the DaVinci defaults. Okay, so the first one is C. If you hit C on your keyboard, that will bring up the cutting or like splicing tool so you can cut sections out of your video. The next one you're gonna wanna know is V. If you hit V on your keyboard, then that will change over to the selector tool so that you can select the section that you just cut, and then you can hit delete on your keyboard to get rid of that section. Hot tip, rather than just grabbing your clip and moving it over to line up with the rest of the timeline, which sometimes you might mess up and, you know, not get it exactly. Instead, all you need to do is while you're, you know, in your selector tool, select that section of the timeline and then hit delete to ripple delete the remaining part of your clip to join part that you just took a section out of. C and V are for sure my most used keyboard shortcuts, and it will save you so much time rather than having to use your mouse to go up and select the little arrow here or the little razor tool all the time. Now, another tip, when you are previewing footage in your source panel here, before you've actually added it to the timeline, there's a few keyboard shortcuts that are gonna save you a ton of time. As you are playing back the clip here, of course, you can press space to play. Once you see the part of the clip you want to include, say, you know, okay, I see I made a mistake there. So now I'm gonna press I on my keyboard to set my endpoint. And then I'm gonna press the O on my keyboard now to set the out point. And you can see on this timeline, it's specified this is the section of the clip that I'm going to use. Now, of course, at this point, you could click and drag either the entire clip by clicking on, you know, the image here, and that would bring the audio and the video. Or you could mouse over and select either just audio or just video, and again, click and drag that onto the timeline. But the quickest way is again with a keyboard shortcut. So let's say you've just hit the out button, you've pressed space to pause the video. Now you can just hit the comma key on your keyboard and it automatically adds both video and audio to the end of your sequence here. If there's a way to make the comma key only add the video and not the audio, I would love to know that, but as far as I know, it has to add both together. But this is a very quick way of going through all of your footage and selecting out only the segments that you actually want to use in your video without having to even touch your mouse really. By the way, I feel like I do need to say the ultimate hack for editing your videos faster is getting somebody else's help with it, which is exactly what my team at Creatorly Media is here for. If you didn't know, I have a small agency, a small team of video editors that edit for YouTubers and video podcasters. The thing is, learning to edit quickly, while of course it is a great skill to have, it also is quite a learning curve. Applying all of my tips will definitely help, but it still takes lots of time and practice. So for some creators, it just legitimately makes sense to invest in outsourcing so they can free up their time to do other things than learning how to be a faster editor. If that happens to be you, we'd love to help you out over at Creatorly. I'll leave the link in the description so you can check out all of the details of our services. We currently have a few openings for a few new clients. So yeah, reach out if you are into that. But otherwise, for everybody else, let's keep going with the tips. Okay, now my third tip for you is a paid feature, but it is so convenient and it saves you so much time. So I had to show you. Basically, you can use the audio transcription from your video to automatically cut out all of your pauses. Let me show you. Okay, so let's say we want to take this long talking head clip where I know I took a lot of pauses to look at my script and I want to automatically cut them out. All I need to do is right click on that clip and go down to audio transcription. And then click transcribe. We'll just give that a quick second to do its thing. Now it's gonna pull up this panel that shows us the transcription that it made. And as you scroll through, you see all these points where there's an ellipsis, and that indicates a point where I paused for several seconds and it's just kind of blank. Now what I can do is just click on this little X in front of the dot, dot, dots icon here. And that will, as you can see, remove all of these pauses. Then all I need to do is click in the text somewhere and then go Command A to select it all. Alternatively, if you knew you only wanted to include a certain portion of the transcript in your video, you could actually just like select part of it. But for the sake of this, I'm gonna select my entire clip. Once I've selected everything here, I'm just gonna go ahead and click this little button to add all of the clips to the end of my timeline. So as you can see, Resolve has gone ahead and cut out all of my pauses. So now what I would do is run through the timeline and just basically make refinements. So you can see actually in this case, there's like a whole section here that should have been cut out. So we'll just get rid of that. While it definitely does cut out pauses, it doesn't make quite as like tight of cuts as I would personally do. So the way I edit my videos is I will literally just be playing this back and I'll be visually identifying spots along the timeline where there's a cut and I feel like, it's not quite as tight as I would like. So like, honestly, while I am playing and I'm listening and I'm like deciding if this is the take I like, I'll hit C on my keyboard and then I'll just go ahead and like cut out these segments, switch to V, delete, and then delete this. And normally I'm able to do that before the playhead even gets to that section. So it's almost as if I am like editing the video while I'm watching it. So I've done it there. I can see there's a gap here. So I'm hitting C, cut, V, select, delete, and so on. Using this method, I'm able to use Resolve to kind of do a rough cut so I don't have to like take out as big of pauses. But then as I go, I'm taking a look and I'm just visually identifying like this is a pause where it's gonna be silent. I don't really want that. So I'm gonna cut that out on both ends and just make that a bit of a tighter cut. Something that I also like to do in my videos that you might have noticed is I kind of like when one clip of me talking sort of blends into the next. And the way I achieve that is just by selecting this clip, for example, dragging the audio down onto the audio 2 track, and then I'll just click and drag this over the slightest amount. So you can see the audio waveform from this section overlaps just a little bit with the audio waveform from this clip. And then I'll do the same over here. I just find this makes it feel very fluid and seamless. There's never like a pause of dead air, but every so often for the sake of emphasis, for the sake of ending a section, I will include a pause just so it's not always like I'm talking over myself. Another major time-saving technique when you need extra visuals, but you don't have time to create the animations or shoot the extra footage yourself, is to use Storyblocks, the sponsor of today's video. Storyblocks is an online stock media library that has all of the creative assets that you need to craft an engaging YouTube video. They've got tons of stock footage, animation templates, sound effects, background music, and more. For example, if you need a time lapse of the Champs-Élysées at sunrise, you can get that on Storyblocks. If you need some artistic and aesthetic close-up shots of the process of making coffee, you can find that on Storyblocks. If you remember earlier, I mentioned some of my go-to assets that I reuse video after video, like this light leaks overlay, and then also this kind of like film grain effect. I actually found both of those on Storyblocks. I've been using Storyblocks very consistently since about 2018, so it's been a while. So I can confidently recommend them to you as a great resource for content creators to help you make
your videos better.
It's just so convenient to have a go-to place where I know I can find my sound effects, my background music, stock footage of like literally anything. So if you think that would be helpful for you as well, I highly recommend checking out Storyblocks. You can go to storyblocks.com/Katie to sign up or check out the link in the description. And thanks again to Storyblocks for sponsoring today's video. Okay, these last two tips I really want you to implement today. Like seriously, start doing them right after this video because they're very easy and they're gonna save you a lot of time. The first thing is to use the search feature so that you can find your files in the media pool. Okay, all you have to do for this is go up to the top of the media pool panel and click on the little magnifying glass. While you're here, you're gonna wanna click on this little arrow and make sure that you have all bins selected because then it'll search everything, not just the bin that you currently have open. From there, you can just type in whatever you're looking for. So if I'm looking for my classic mouse click sound effect, I can just search mouse. And here we go. As you can see, I have a few. Or let's say I'm looking for that light leaks clip. I can search for that. And there we are. Now, obviously, this is why it's so important that you actually rename your files that you're planning to use over and over again so that they'll appear when you search. Like, for example, I can just type in like yoga, and here I've got like a few different clips of me like doing yoga that I can use as B-roll. Or like, oh my gosh, you don't even wanna see how many clips I have if I search coffee. Like, there is a lot here to choose from. And that just makes it so easy to pull in the clips that you want because you can kind of just envision as you're editing, oh, it would be great to like show a clip of me here, like writing in my journal. So then I search journal and like, look, I've got this scene that I recorded of me doing just that. Second thing I want you to do is use the favorites feature. That's in the effects panel. So all you have to do to open that up is go up here to the top and click on the effects button, and then it'll appear in the bottom left-hand corner. As you're searching through the various effects, you might come across one that you think you're gonna use multiple times. All you have to do is hover over it and click on this little star button and it'll be added to your favorites folder. These tips will undoubtedly help you speed up your editing process, which will also help you stay more consistent with posting your videos, which we all know is super important to growth here on YouTube. If you're planning on sticking to the free version of DaVinci Resolve for now, you should check out this video that I made next because I dive into some of my favorite effects and other editing features that are included for free. And if you want to see more DaVinci Resolve editing tutorials for me, make sure to let me know in the comments because I find these videos really fun to make, but I want to know what you all want to learn. As always, thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having adventures and following your dreams, and I'll catch you in the next video. Bye!